This morning we're offering a mass for several persons, Charles and Eunice Juist, Laura Smith LeBlanc, Gail Juist McGrew, Casey and Doris Smith Juist, and the Lindy families, Melissa Lindy and Regina Barrio. So let us begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. So we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins, and we ask the Lord's pardon. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. We humbly implore your mercy, Lord, protect us in all dangers, through the prayers of the Bishop St. Nicholas, that the way of salvation may lie open before us, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will be exalted. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers. They will rejoice with joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them, and the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord and the splendor of our God. The strength of the hands that are free, that may burn the knees that are weak. Say that those whose hearts are bright, be strong, fear not. Here is your God, here comes the vindication, the divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then the lame leaps like a stag, and the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools, the thirsty ground springs of water. The bowl where jackals lurk will be a marsh for the reed and papyrus. A highway will be there called the Holy Way. No one unclean may pass over it, nor wolves go astray on it. No lion will be there, nor beast of prey go upon to be met upon him. It is those with the journey to make, and on it the redeemed will walk. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion, singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet the joy and gladness and sorrow, and mourning will grieve. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response story of the song, our God will come to save us.
Our God will come to save us.
I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him. Glory dwelling in our land.
Our God will come to save us.
Kindness and truth shall be justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and the justice shall look down from heaven.
Our God has come to save us.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him, and salvation along the way of his death.
Our God has come to save us.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Behold, the King will come, the Lord of the earth, and he himself will lift the yoke of our captivity.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Pharisees, one day as Jesus was teaching, Pharisees and teachers of the law, who had come from every village of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem, they were sitting there, and the power of the Lord was with him for healing. And some men brought on a stretcher, a man who was paralyzed. They were trying to bring him in, sitting in his presence, but not finding a way to bring him in, because of the crowd, they went upon the roof and lowered him on the stretcher through the tiles into the middle of the front of Jesus. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, "As for you, your sins are forgiven." Then the scribes and Pharisees began to ask themselves, "Who is this who speaks blasphemies? Who but God alone can forgive sins?" Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them in reply, "What are you thinking in your hearts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the one who was paralyzed, "I say to you, rise, pick up your stretcher, and go home." He stood up immediately before them, picked up what he had been lying on, and went home glorifying God. Then astonishing to see the Lord is with us. Difficulties that we're going through, we're all focused on the difficulty and not realizing that the Lord is right here beside us. It mentions in that first reading something that I think is important for us to remember always, and that is the Word of God stands forever. God's Word is not going to change. In spite of the best efforts of men, priests, bishops, and other folks of great intelligence, God's Word is going to remain. And it takes us a while sometimes to realize that. Because we have our plans, we want to do this, we think this would be a great change here. And we realize when we start off on those particular plans that we have and stay away and move away from the plan of God, God's Word, there's always consequences. But sometimes it takes us a while to see that. And then when we do, sometimes we're a little afraid, we're a little embarrassed to say, "Oh, I need to go back to the truth." But that's okay. God doesn't have a problem with that. God's waiting. God's walking by our side, waiting for us to wake up. So first messenger says, "Fear not, cry out. Here is your God. Our God is right here." So we're preparing right now in this time of Advent to welcome him again. The Lord has promised from centuries, who knows how long before Jesus' birth, how long the promise was made to send the Messiah. So we've been celebrating 2,000 years, now we're coming up on 2,000 years, the fact that God is faithful to his promises. It's just that on God's time. So we need to remember that God's Word is with us forever. Come to this gospel today where the Pharisees were shocked that Jesus said, "Your sins are forgiven," because they didn't think there was anybody that could, God could do that. And that's true. Only God can forgive sins. But God has chosen some people to be able to forgive sins in the name of Jesus. And that's a great gift that God has given to the church, is the ability to have our sins forgiven and to be clean again, so that we can walk down the street with our head held high, and we know that God loves us, and that God is with us, and God strengthens us, and God doesn't have a problem with the things that we do that are not acceptable, if we just take responsibility for them and say, "Lord, I blew it. I'm sorry." That's all God wants to hear. "I'm sorry." So, these people were shocked that some man, as they thought it was only a man, we're talking about Jesus here, who has that power because he is God. But later on, he gives that power to man. So, God is always taking care of us. It's just sometimes we have difficulty seeing that because of our problems. God is always there. So, as we continue to prepare ourselves for the birth of Jesus, let's keep that in mind. That statement at the beginning there, that the Word of God, the Word of our God stands forever.
us stand and bring our needs before the Lord today. There was a lot of people asking for the mass to be offered for them, probably mostly family members, so the Lord remembers all those names. And so we're going to ask the Lord again to think about those people that have asked for their for this mass to be offered for them and bless them. And if they've already passed away, to welcome them into heaven. So for this intention, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, yeah, praise.
And for our daily in thanksgiving for the gift of our life today, in spite of the difficulties that we may be facing, that we are gifted, we are grateful to the Lord for this gift of our life that gives us another opportunity to witness to the truth of the Lord. So for this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, yeah, praise.
For what else should we pray this morning?
For peace in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Mrs. Decato, who's in her last days, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For all those people that don't know Jesus yet and all the great gifts he brings to us, they will come to know, many of them will come to know, many more will come to know about Jesus as we prepare ourselves to celebrate his birth here very shortly. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the people that have many needs this day and don't know that Jesus is there to help them, that they will open their eyes and call on the Lord for this.
As we have received the bread, we offer you fruit of the earth and work of human hands that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
So pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our glory, God, along with his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design he formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. So with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glories without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate this memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. So at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, the glory is yours.
Yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Peace of the Lord. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Thank you. Visit us in peace, that we may rejoice before you with a blameless heart. Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray, for even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And thank you for coming.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Mike.
Me too.
Oh,
everybody.
It's like it just coming at you different.
Oh, the devil's out here.